What impressed me and Ronnie was the yellow after this red and colour. This yellow here, you could quite easily play a safety shot, but he's took the ball by the horns, trying to make something happening because he's struggling. Yeah. Gone in, great shot.
Absolutely fantastic. So, I mean, ideally he'd want to be coming in at level at the break, but 3-1 down, he'll come out. Very important fifth frame, but in this fourth frame, Barry Hawkins' red really jumps out. Ronnie, what a shot.
Yeah, this last red, frame four, even Stevens, and he's just clean as a whistle in the pocket, right near the corner bag, perfect on the blue, a real curing shot, and that's what Barry's good at, you know, he's a very clean striker, the ball, you see this boy stays down on the shot, the cue's not going up in the air, it's parallel to the cloth of the cue, and, you know, he gets a lot of bite in the ball, which makes him a great striker of the ball, which gives him a lot of consistency.
Yeah, he's all business, isn't he? And we were watching from the wonderful position we have in the studio, and you guys were pointing out just how methodical he is, Jimmy, in every shot he takes. It's almost professorial in how he does the same thing every time.
Yeah, he's got a really good pre-shot routine, and he's got a very straight action, and that's why he hits the ball, you know, they go in the middle of the pockets.
Mm-hmm. Most players, I mean, Ronnie, talk to me about sort of that process for you, because you're so fast. Does it change every time?
Well, if you look at,
so methodical.
You look at Barry here, you know, he's very square to the ball, you know, the cue's very parallel. Watch his body, it doesn't move, he stays down on the shot, and it's a bit like a golfer. You have to complete the shot. It's about the backswing and finishing the swing, and Barry does that as well as anybody in the game.
Yeah, what about yourself? Because you're so fast, it's hard to
well,
the spot.
I don't think about what I do. I just, you know, I just, I've had good habits ingrained in me as a kid. I'm sure Barry doesn't think about what he does, but if I'm struggling, I will actually go back to consciously thinking about a pre-shot routine until I start getting my rhythm going. And when I get my rhythm going, I'm like, happy days again. You're freewheeling again. But Barry, you know, is a bit much more methodical player than I am.
Right, well, brilliant. Listen, having you two here is an absolute treat on Eurosport, and we have our own table. How plush is that? So, Jimmy, Ronnie, you bad boy. you don't want to know. Jimmy, talk us through a little bit more about sort of that process.
Well, you know, you have to step into the shot. My pre-shot routine is I have a round butt on my cue, and I just turn it round till I find the grain. And basically, you just want to just, you know, go through the ball straight. I don't really have... I'm a bit like Ronnie. If I am struggling, then I would try to sort of find a pre-shot routine just to get myself going.
What yourself, Ronnie?
Well, my pre-shot routine would be just to stand behind the ball, look at the ball, look at the pocket, look at the line, and I'm just basically just walking into the shot, left foot first, and just try and just stay down on the shot and just play straight through the white, as if the object ball isn't there. You just try and cue through every shot as sweetly and smoothly as you can, really.
I mean, for amateur players who play a little bit here and there, whether it's snooker or pool, our process is putting the cocktail down or the beer just before we hit it. What advice would you give those players right now who are 16, 17, they want to come through, they want to become professional, and they probably practice the shots a lot, Jimmy, but how important is the bit before the shot?
It's very important to have your bridge hand, you know, solid on the table. Barry Hawkins there, one of the top players in the world, he has a terrible habit of when he's on the cushion, he puts his cue there and he cues across his finger, and it's totally wrong way of holding the cue. But Ronnie will tell you, he goes through the ball clean as a whistle with that. But for a player that's starting out, you should have your cue there and your bridge hand should be solid, and make sure you keep still on the shot.
I mean, the setup is so important. If you showed me a photo of someone on the shot, I could tell you straight away whether he's a good player or not.
Yeah.
And I do believe a little bit, like, if you get the foundations and the setup right, it's very automatic, you can't aim. And if you're in the right position, you're able to deliver the cue along the line. It's a little bit like golf. If you're in the wrong position, hands are going to try and make up for it. So it's about being efficient, really. And Barry, John Higgins, Judd Trump, Neil Robertson, they're experts at that. You know, Selby probably would have a little bit more of a difficulty on his setup, but he makes up for it through his technical play, and he's now around the table. So, you know, it doesn't have to be all about technique, but as a snooker player, to be efficient, it's about getting in the right position to allow the cue to be delivered on a straight line.
It's interesting the amount of times you guys use the golf comparison. Mm. I was watching a piece in Rory McIlroy's swing, and they were saying this guy's going to play for 15 years longer than some other players because it's so classic and effortless and doesn't put pressure in the body. Is there a comparison with snooker in terms of when you're playing a long tournament, a long format, in terms of it being effortless, in terms of being classic?
Well, I look at John Higgins and I think 41, they say 40 is the new 30s. He's still winning tournaments now because he's so efficient, he's so good amongst the balls, he has a great technical game, but you look at his technique and that and you think, you wonder how he can miss a ball. Everyone struggles, but when he gets it right, he's still able to compete and win tournaments. And I think if you haven't got a great technique, as you get a bit older, you'll get sussed out because the modern day game is about power play and John can still play all the power shots.
Yeah, absolutely fantastic. That's the type of insight you can expect as Eurosport continues to increase its snooker coverage all throughout this season. In fact, this Home Nations Championship is live and exclusive on Eurosport. So we're looking forward to seeing you after the break. More insight from Ronnie and Jimmy and more snooker from the quarterfinals. It's White against Hawkins. It's 3-1 Hawkins.